waiting years for you, my dear. I'll be alone.
You appear from the night, my dear, like I was home. Happy Junior Friday, which I love. How are you ladies doing this morning? Tell me how you're doing in the chat. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Jessica will be getting on, but she is currently on a strategy call with one of you lovely ladies, and the time got a little messed up, so they're a little bit late this morning, but she will be getting on shortly. Okay, so I'm just going to jump right into it. If no one has questions currently, I'll just start answering them. Any questions that come up, ladies, just put them in the chat, okay? This day is really for you to answer all of your questions, to allow you to feel more at ease, you know, for just all the information. We've had a lot of great feedback. Thank you, all of you, for giving the feedback you have. A few ladies have said you're trying to process because it's so much information, which it is so much information. So today is kind of the day to like nail down the information, be like, I was drinking through a fire hose the last 3 days. I don't feel super clear here. And then let's talk through it, okay? Nice, fourth day of consistency. Shayla, on what? Is that working out or on these vids or both? Tara, busy meal prepping. Heck yeah, girl. What a great space to listen while you're meal prepping. That's really awesome. All right, ladies. So we have a whole list of questions here. I'm just going to, and my phone is down. I'm looking at the name of the comment, so that's why I keep looking down randomly. So I'm going to tell you a few of the questions that we're about to answer. And then again, please, today is for you. Okay, drop your questions. So we have, how often should I take a rest day? How many days per week should I train glutes? How do I know if I'm eating enough? I don't know if I'm tracking correctly. I don't know what to eat. I'm bored of diet food. Sound like you? I've said it. How do I know if my form is correct? Am I eating too many carbs? How many times should I weigh myself? I can't stay on track on the weekends. How do I stay consistent? Okay, those are going to be some topics. So I'm going to go ahead and go into carbs because this is one of my favorite to talk about. All right. How do you know if you're eating? Well, actually, I'm going to answer two. How do I know if I'm eating enough? And how do I know if I'm eating too many carbohydrates? Okay. Let me ask you this. How many are afraid to eat carbohydrate? I want to know, are you afraid to eat carbs or do you love carbs and you eat all the carbs? Drop it in the chat. I'm going to keep rolling, but I want to see your answers. Okay. The media and social media is pumping on us. Carbs are bad. Carbs are bad. Carbs are bad. And it is just not true, which is what we've been teaching. If today is your first day, welcome. Definitely go back and watch the last 3 days. We do have a replay link. If you ladies need that, I can have someone drop it. Love it. Love the carbs. Little both. Okay. Totally understandable. Quick thing, the overconsumption of carbs is what causes you to gain fat. But did you know the overconsumption of protein also causes you to gain fat? And the overconsumption of fat also causes you to gain fat. Side note, because I love tangents, there have been research studies shown that when comparing the two, overconsumption of fat and overconsumption of carb, the people who overconsume fat gain more fat than overconsuming carb, which blows my mind that keto exists, even with that science out, right? Okay, don't be afraid. Food is not here to control us. It is here for us to control it. If you feel like it controls you, totally normal. There's definitely solutions and strategies and tools that can take you on the other side, okay? It's just patience, grace for yourself, right? Acceptance of self. Okay, so how do I know if I'm eating enough? And how do I know if I'm eating too many carbs? First and foremost, I would say collect data. Collect data. And what I mean by that is track your food. I always recommend MyFitnessPal. There's a lot of great ones out there. That's just what we use by the pro version, so you can set everything to macros, okay? I'll always say that. So track your food, everything that you're eating, not what you feel like tracking, but every single piece of food that you're eating, just track it. Side note for those who may be newer, you can scan barcodes on MyFitnessPal and everything just pops right up. So it's so easy. Another quick tip, if the green check mark is on MyFitnessPal, it's a better option, a more accurate option than a food without the green check mark. Just means it's been verified. When in doubt, scan and check the label. Check the actual food label. The food label is most accurate. Okay. Versus MyFitnessPal. Okay, so collect data. Collect all your food, track all your food, and track your progress. We talked a little bit about this yesterday, actually, and Tuesday. Weight. Is weight most accurate? Actually, not at all. Especially if you're on your cycle, it will be like, I gained 5 pounds, oh my God. It's like, whoa, whoa. You did not gain any weight. You did not gain any fat, right? Your body might be holding on to water, but you didn't gain any fat, okay? So this is why we do pictures and measurements. So the best way to know, am I eating too many carbs specifically, would be to track your food and to track your progress. So you know, this is what I'm eating. This is the result. Good morning, everybody. This is the result that I'm getting. That's really the only true way to understand if what you're currently doing, what your current habits are, what your current eating habits are right for you, okay? How do I know if I'm eating enough? Again, I would say track in MyFitnessPal and track your metrics, because until you really understand your body, until you really understand, oh, my body's craving a little bit of carb right now. My body's craving a little bit of protein right now. My body's feeling this. My body's feeling this. Until you really can hone in and truly understand yourself, which takes time, then I would say get a coach first and foremost. But if you don't get a coach, track your food and track your progress. If you are eating 1,000 calories, plus or minus a little bit, and have not had gastric bypass surgery, 99.9% chance you're eating too little, okay? There are exceptions for everyone. People who have had gastric bypass surgery can only handle about 1,200 calories. Do not shame them for eating that amount. That is what their body can handle. Okay. We work with you where you're at. We work with all the limitations that you bring. It's just like getting into a relationship, right? Your significant other, like you guys just kind of take on each other's trauma, right? You take on where you're at with each other and you just love them and do your best, right, with where you're at. It's kind of a weird analogy, but that's like literally what came to mind. So whatever is going on with the person, like just know every single human is different. So try to avoid grabbing onto cookie cutter statements and being like, oh, I'm not doing this exact thing. That means I'm doing it wrong. Not necessarily. What is your body telling you? Is your energy increasing? It is. That's a good indicator you're eating enough. Are you getting tired? Are you getting cranky? Are you not able to focus as well? Is your libido dropping? Are you missing menstrual cycles? That may be an indicator you're eating too little. Okay. Good morning, ladies. Okay. Beautiful. Did I answer that enough? If you have additional, If you have additional questions on that topic, please let me know. Okay. And I'll answer that a little bit more in depth. For those who say, I don't like eating a lot of carbs, ask yourself why. Why? Find the root. Where did that come from? When was the point you decided, I don't want to eat that many carbs? And why did you decide that? Did you have a problem with it before? Right? So we need to dig into that, because a lot of times when we see something over and over, like social media telling us to do keto, subconsciously we create a fear of carbohydrate. When in reality, it's actually just the news, basically, right? Social media is like the news, right? The news creates fear that actually a lot of times doesn't exist. Tangent, I was in the military when we thought we were going to war with North Korea, and I was in South Korea, and what the news was saying was not even true. Completely different things were really happening, but they were trying to provoke fear into America. Insane, okay? A lot of crap is like that. So you have to weed out the garbage and take in only the quality information that makes sense, that has research behind it, and that makes your life thrive, okay? Everything else, dump it, trash. Okay, so carbohydrates, I've said this before, I said this all yesterday, carbohydrates build muscle mass. If you are lifting weights 4 to 6 times a week, do not be afraid of carb, okay? I don't currently, but I've had a few clients, we got them over 300 grams of carbohydrate per day, and one of them weighed 115 pounds, and she was eating over 300 grams of carbohydrate per day, okay? How? Extreme metabolic health, bringing a ton of health to your metabolism to teach your body how to rapidly process and metabolize food and use it to pack on sexy muscle mass. It's amazing. So don't be afraid of carbohydrate. It's a tool that we can use to our advantage, okay? When used incorrectly, you can start us back. But same as everything else. Same as everything else, okay? Cool, ladies. Okay. Let me know if you have questions on that, okay? Just should be getting on any second. Okay, so let's go to how do I know if I'm tracking correctly? We hear this all the time. We hear this all the time. Sometimes women here she is. I'm tracking. Here, let me jump her on. What's up?
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm good. How are you guys? I'm so sorry I'm late.
Don't worry. I told them why. You're good.
Much love.
So I just went over, am I eating too many carbs? What was the other question? Let's see. I went over, how do I know if I'm eating enough? I went over, am I eating too many carbs? I don't like to eat a lot of carbs. I talked to him a little bit about carb fear. And then I was about to go into, how do I know if I'm tracking correctly? So I'll go ahead and go to that. And then you can take over next question, whichever one you want.
Sounds good.
Cool. Okay, ladies. So how do I know if I'm tracking correctly? So we get this all the time. Women are like, I don't even know if it's worth my time because I'm tracking, but I feel like I'm guessing. So I don't even know if it's working and my weight's not changing. My body's not changing. It's probably that I'm tracking incorrectly. Well, it's probably that the macros aren't quite right for you, honestly. Now, the way you know you're tracking correctly is A, have a coach that teaches you, right? Quick metaphor. Two people are going up the mountain. One person, never been up the mountain, but they grab your arm. They're like, I know for a fact we can get up the mountain together. We got this, right? You go up, you kind of take some weird detours, but eventually, hopefully, you get to the top. There's another person that's like, yo, what's up? I've been to the mountain 50 times, been down and back, took a ton of people with me. Let's go. You get up, we're like, we're going to take a drink of water here. Then we're going to go this way. We're going to have a quick snack, go to the top, take some selfies, get back down right in time for happy hour. Which one are you going to go with, right? Like, we want the fastest one. So common sense, right? I mean, that it's just the fastest, most efficient way, okay? But if you don't have a coach, I would say practice, 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 practice. That is how you know. In fact, my reel yesterday was like, I'm scared to try. It's like, no, don't be afraid. Just practice, right? Scan the barcode, weigh the food, eat the food over and over and over. The small errors that may be taking place will naturally weed themselves out over time for sure. With dining out, how do you know if you're tracking correctly? Again, practice, but also having someone to instruct you. Like, what I have my girls do when they're going out, I'm like, take a picture of your food, track it, send me both, and I'll tell you, A, if I think that's spot on, or B, anywhere I think maybe we could fine tune. Yeah. I would never tell someone to bring a scale to a restaurant. You can. I've done it with wine, but it is not necessary. Like, we're here for the lifestyle and for the balance. So practice. Yeah. Practice, 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 practice without fear, without shame. Just do you, because it's better than not. It's better than not practicing. It's better than not trying because you're afraid you're doing it wrong. Right.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Please don't bring your scale to the restaurant. I've had so many people ask me that. I'm like, no, I can't bring my scale there. Like, if I'm going out for a burger, guys, I'm having a burger. Like, I'm going to track it as best I can.
I love it.
Oh, that's amazing. Excuse me. Okay, so I don't know what to eat and I'm bored of diet food. Whew, guys, I'm not going to lie. I've felt this one myself. Yeah, if you're eating the same thing over and over again, and if that's not something that aligns with you personally, if that's not your vibe, don't feel bad, okay? You can totally change up your food and still enjoy it. A couple strategies that I use for this, honestly, is I kind of look at my week each week and I think about, okay, what fruit sources, veggie sources, protein sources, carb sources did I have that I really, really enjoy? What do I kind of want to keep? And what do I want to kind of get rid of for next week? And I will plan different grocery shops based on that and look at some recipes. I use Pinterest. I've used Meal Prep on Fleek. There's tons of sites out there for making really creative versions of what you really like to eat in a ton of different ways that makes it feel like a new dish, honestly. One of my personal favorites is ground turkey tacos. And it is like so good. But if I were to just eat ground turkey and broccoli and white rice with no sauce by itself every day, I'm going to be so bored. Like, I can't do that. Personally, I don't mind eating the same thing all the time, but it does get really boring, right? Also kind of have to be really careful with that label of diet food, because it's like, what is that creating in your mind, right? Like, we're living a lifestyle of flexibility, right? We're tracking macros. There's no reason why we can't have 80-20 some days, 70-30, okay, right? I'm just saying, 70-30, and that's cool too. But if we're restricting ourselves and being like, no, I'm hitting my macros, but I have to stay within diet food, it's like, well, there's the problem right there. You have to switch that mindset. No food has to be a diet food, and you don't have to stick to it. You don't have to always go, you know, sugar-free, calorie-free, like everything. Like, you want to have the chocolate, put the chocolate in your macros and eat it. I definitely have chocolate every morning with my coffee and a balanced meal, but with my coffee, right? So if you're feeling like you might have that mindset, which I know I've personally struggled with a lot, just maybe flip it and take the initiative to like make it fun, plan recipes for yourself that you really like. I'm actually going to be posting a pumpkin chocolate chip recipe tomorrow. pancakes. You can also use them for muffins, so that's nice. So like, make it fun, and they're really like low calorie, they're macro friendly, filled with pumpkin, like eggs, the whole bit. Like, you can make it really interesting for yourself and really enjoy your food. It takes a bit of effort in the beginning, but eventually you will save all of those recipes in My Fitness Pal, and you'll just have to click them, put your portion in, and track them. So I don't know. Do you have, Chris, anything you want to add to that?
You need to teach me how to do that recipe thing. I've never done that. And I've had clients say that. I'm like, what? I'm like, I just do quick add, but the recipe sounds easier.
Quick add is, definitely such a nice tool, especially if you're on the go. But recipes is so nice because you can like literally take a recipe from Pinterest and you can copy the URL. And when you add a recipe, it says add manually or add from web, and you can copy and paste the URL. It pastes all of the ingredients for you. You can change anything and swap out whatever you put in, took out, put it all in Grams brand name. So it's easy for MyFitnessPal to find it, and it will locate all of the ingredients for you. You review it to make sure it's correct, and then you save the recipe, and it calculates the macros per serving per recipe. So if the recipe yields 12 pancakes, you put in 12 and then you just add one, and it does all the macros for you. It's like such a life-changing feature. I love that feature in MyFitnessPal.
That's life-changing because I would weigh and with a pencil and a paper, write down every weight, manually add it in, divide it by 12, and like quick add the macros.
You're the Einstein of macro counting.
Yeah, MyFitnessPal, Shannon, yeah.
Yeah, MyFitnessPal.
Oh my God.
You have your own recipe too. Like if you've created your own recipe and it's not, you're not adding it from the web, you can add manual ingredients to that way, like you did in weight. Like I always weigh everything in grams or mils and then I'll put it in. Yeah.
That's amazing. Ladies, quick thing, grams and milliliters on your scale and in My Fitness Pal are the exact same. Exact same. Okay. I had a question come in this morning. She said it was coming in as ounces. Oh, Emily, I think it's you. She said it was coming in as ounces. She didn't know how to change it to grams or milliliters. If you need a video, let me know because I can pop you over actually the same video I sent her. But basically, you just tap it, the serving, I think it says like serving size or serving unit. You tap it and then you can change it to cups. Don't use that. Don't use tablespoons. To grams, to ounces. Then when you click your serving amount, I think it's fraction, not decimal. Let me check really quick. Okay. So can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay. So the top right here where it says milliliter, you can click that and then all these other options show up. And then where it says number of serving, make sure it's on decimal instead of fraction. So you can just type it instead of having to scroll and it only goes to 99. Okay. That's awesome, Jessica. Thank you.
No problem. That's such a great feature in MyFitnessPal.
That really is. Okay. Sweet. No, that was perfect. That was a beautiful explanation. I have nothing to add. Thank you.
No problem.
Okay. So Jess, do you want to answer another one? Because I answered a couple.
Yeah, for sure. So how do you know if your form is correct? Oof, big, big topic. Okay, first of all, if you get a coach, I mean, if you have a coach, right? It helps to have somebody look at you objectively because like so many times, like I have been like, okay, I thought my form on this one thing is perfect. And then I'll take a video of myself and I'll look and I'll be like, oh, you know what? I didn't actually keep the most neutral spine there. Or, you know what? My abs could have been a little bit more engaged there. And that's okay. Like we're all learning. And just to lay it out, we all start with crappy form. That's just the way it is. Like I did, I'm sure Kristen did right before we became coaches. There's still things that we're learning and fixing and there's new exercises that we learn, right? So it's totally normal. Please don't be embarrassed. But the one thing that I want to encourage you to do is to be resourceful. If you don't have a coach, YouTube can be such a powerful tool. So can Instagram if you're following the right people. So make sure that you're not just taking your exercise information from anybody. Same with nutrition, of course. You want to make sure that it's credible information. Otherwise, we end up with things like HIIT workouts that aren't actually HIIT workouts. and are mainly booty bands. Not that booty bands are bad, but they might not get you where you want to go for the goal that you're trying to achieve, right? So looking it up on YouTube, you can type in the specific exercise name. So like for those of you who follow me on Instagram, the 45 degree back extension that we posted this morning. If you were to type in 45 degree back extension into YouTube, you get so many videos, and you're going to look for the most credible one. I would say look for a leader in the industry, somebody like Brett Contreras, or like, Lauren Simpson's a great person to follow for form and stuff like that. But looking for those people that you can trust, and getting the breakdown and all the form cues that they will actually give you in the video, you get to see the visual representation of it, and you can watch it, practice it, film yourself, and then compare the two videos. That is like probably the best thing that you can do. It's also going to stop you from being in the gym when you film yourself, right? And kind of looking to the side while you're like doing a deadlift for some reason. You know, sometimes we do it, and no shame, but what it does is it actually puts your neck in a really compromising position. And it means that your spine is in a very vulnerable place. So you want to make sure that you're protecting yourself there. So definitely YouTube, Instagram, again, if you're following the right accounts, just make sure that it's credible information. And if an exercise is not working for you, find an alternative, right? YouTube can be really amazing for that as well. If you're having trouble learning a certain exercise, right? If you have, if you do know a coach or you follow somebody on Instagram, most people are pretty okay with you popping into their DMs and asking questions too. But again, consider the source. But yeah, I think YouTube was like a huge game changer for me in the beginning of my journey. And I still film my exercises pretty much every time I go to the gym, not just for content, but if I'm trying to improve on a lift, or there's a new one, or something's feeling a little bit off, I'm like, all right, let's have a look at what's going on here so that I can keep improving every time I go into the gym and get the best result that for me and my goals.
Yeah. Just a point of clarification. When she's talking about looking to the side, she's talking about watching yourself in the mirror.
Yes. When you're watching yourself in the mirror while you're doing a deadlift or really any movement, it's not good for your form. It's not good for your spine. Basically does not protect your spine as soon as you turn your head, yeah, which is very dangerous, right? We want to protect that.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Yeah. Cool. Thank you.
No problem.
Okay. Excuse me. All right. Let's go to, I think I answered the ones on the top. Let's go to, I can't stay on track during the weekend or at night. How do I stay consistent? Get a coach. First thing. Wow. Accountability and having someone create a plan for you. It's so hard to do on our own. There's too much emotion involved. I have been doing this for 11 years. I still can't do it for myself. There's too much emotion involved. And when you're down or on your period or going through a breakup or going through work stress, you can't be the one to pick yourself up when you're the one feeling down. You can't. If you can, you're amazing. Tell me your secrets. But it's so hard. So of course that would be the quickest, easiest way, right? Accountability, all that. But here's a few things you can do if you don't have a coach. Get an accountability partner or a significant other and share goals with each other. You know, share, this is where I need help. These are my goals. This is where I need help. If I'm going through the situation where I'm starting to overeat on the weekend, can you have this conversation with me, right? Just very open, vulnerable communication with someone. You can do the 5-2 split like we were talking about. I talked a little bit about it on Monday, and I talked quite a bit about it yesterday, where you have 5 days of lower calories and then 2 days of higher calories. But over the 7-day, right, over 1 week, well, I don't want to say maintenance. So you need to have, so whatever your calorie goal is, you take that goal over 7 days, have 5 of them as lower and 2 of them as higher. So you have more space to play, but you're still hitting the same calorie goal. Okay. So that would be there. Two other ways. One, dig into your why. Why am I doing this? Why am I eating less? Why am I drinking all the water? Why am I going to the gym? Unless we really deeply know what is in it for me. Why would I want to tell myself no on food more than eat the food? Because sometimes when we're stressed or sad or on our period, we don't care. We just want to eat all the food. When our why, when our reason for doing is stronger and louder and bigger than the desire to eat, that's when we have effectively solved the issue of overeating. And I would say it's a continual basis. You have to keep digging into your why. Your why will always change. Like, I was training for a competition for a year and a half. So that was my why of why I didn't do anything pretty much for the most part off plan. Then all of a sudden I was like, I'll just do it for lifestyle. And that was a huge mindset shift. Like, well, what's my reason for not overeating now? Yes, health, but I have a six pack. So what's my reason now when I'm already feeling healthy? Why do I not want to overeat? To be a leader in the industry. Okay, but I'm also a human. So what else? So I had to keep digging and stack up my whys so freaking high that it shadowed the desire to want to overeat. So that's the hugest thing. Journal. We're huge journal advocates. A lot of women are like, I don't even know what to journal. Here's always what I do when I am not sure what to write. I'll open it up and I'll break my life into categories. I'm like, okay, me as a mother. I'm like, how do I feel? That's it. And I'll just total unconscious stream. I'll just write, 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 write. You're the only one reading it. Don't read it with judgment, right? Let it all out. Accept it. It will help you find roots of challenges, of mindset, of beliefs, of everything. Then be like, okay, cool. How do I feel as an athlete or as a person on a weightlifting or fitness journey? Okay, how do I feel as a significant other? How do I feel as a boss? How do I feel as an employee? How do I feel as this, as this, as this? And now you've broken down all these parts of your life and you all of a sudden have this clear picture, like a super deep self-reflection. And then you can kind of move into like, okay, where do I want to go? What are a few areas I want to change to be able to serve myself and naturally those around me better?
Yeah.
The other thing is get high volume foods that like make you feel good to eat, but that are low calories. I've had several clients struggle with overeating at night, and I think all of them we've solved it with popcorn.
Yeah. Corn is such a great option, actually. Yeah.
You can eat so much. It's crunchy, it's salty, or kettle corn, it's sweet. You can like watch a movie and just eat, and it's like 150 calories.
Yeah. The Boom Chicka Pop is like, it's in my pantry right now, guys. That stuff is like a weakness. It's a movie must. You need it.
Oh, sorry. One other thing I'll add is pre-plan it. So some ladies, they were pre-planning dinner, pre-planning their whole day, and then they would overeat. I'm like, well, pre-plan what you're planning on overeating. And it was so confusing. I'm like, no. Pre-plan that evening snack that you can't stop yourself from eating. And why are you stopping yourself from eating it? Just work it into your day. Bam. All of them are losing weight and still getting their nighttime snack.
100%. Yeah, such a mindset shift. I love that.
That shift.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Living the dream. All right.
I love it. Ended on a note. Yeah. I love what you said about journaling so much. I think that that's like such a great way to dig into your why. And like, I completely agree. As we go along our journey, that changes too, right? The reason for doing things, like Kristen said. So it's really nice to become aware that way. And just as a quick side note, I use my journal maybe at the end of the week, at the end of the month sometimes. I know you and I have talked about this as a way to reflect and write down all the things that I did really well. And maybe a couple of things that I want to improve on, not in a way to beat yourself up by any means, but just to bring self-awareness and focus, right? To help yourself grow that way. So it's really cool. And it's nice to be able to celebrate those wins. It's so important.
Real quick. So Allison put, I've always put the things I want most in first, then plan my day around it.
Yes.
She has hit 7 out of 7 days macro compliance every single day since she started this program. What Allison said. 6-ish weeks ago, she's been 100% compliant the entire time and crushing results. And look what she does. Mm-hmm. She puts it in first, plans a day around it.
Wow. That is amazing. Great job, Allison. Way to slay the program.
You should see, you should look at her metrics. I'm like, yeah, girl, like every check. And I'm like, yeah, so good. So good.
Oh, that is so badass. That's amazing. It's true though. Like that's what I do too. I mean, that's what we do when we want to eat out. So if you do that every day, there's really no reason why you can't have it. So smart.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Awesome. You're up, girl. I've already answered all mine.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Which ones did you not answer?
The ones that say Jess.
Oh, I thought you did the top one. Sorry about that.
Oh, no, I did these two right here.
Okay. Okay. Sounds good. All right. So how often should I take a rest day? I'm, as we saw in the Progressive Overload Live, very passionate about rest days. I love my rest days so much. Okay. There is something to be said for giving your body not just a rest when it sleeps, but for actually kicking your feet up and giving yourself a physical rest, a mental rest as well. But when we're working hard in the gym with a goal, if you're going into the gym and you're hitting your sessions and you're training with intensity and you're training with the intention of working as hard as you can without obliterating yourself, right? You want to stimulate your muscles, not obliterate them, but without obliterating yourself, working really hard in that session and then leaving after being like, yeah, I did exactly what I need to do and feeling okay with resting. We need to kind of recognize, and this is something that I struggled with for a long time, that more is always better mindset, but it's not. More is just more. And more is just more, and it's more stress for your body to adapt to on top of everything else that we have going on in our lives, which, let's face it, sometimes could be a lot of obstacles. So we need to give ourselves that break. We need to give our mind and our body a break. When we're working hard in the gym, we're stimulating our muscles, but where they actually change and recover and grow and repair is when we're resting, whether that is sleeping or if we're just actually taking a day to not move. So I would say taking a rest day, a full rest day, at least once a week, like at least once a week. I take two at the moment. Actually, I'm only training 4 days a week. And then I do 3 days of rest or active rest. And that works for me. It just depends on what works for your lifestyle, what your training split looks like, and what your goals actually are. There are times when we train 4 days a week, and there's times when we train 5 days a week, right? When we were on prep, we were training quite a bit more, 6 days a week, yeah, and cardio, right? But that was definitely the more intense end of the spectrum. And we knew that what that was going to be going into it. But for general lifestyle, you definitely need to be resting, or you're leaving gains on the table and you're robbing yourself of results because you're doing too much and your body's like, hey, this is too much stress. You haven't actually given me time to adapt to it and like get used to everything that's going on here. So I can't do what you're asking of me. I can't change the way that you want me to. So no recovery, no rest means no adaptation and a dampened result. So just like next time you feel like, oh, I went for a workout this morning, I should go do HIIT or something like that. Please do not. Please let yourself have a rest and make sure that you're not training every single day. You really don't need to. Like I said, I'm training 4 days a week and I'm seeing results every week. So it's really important to allow yourself that break. So
I'm sorry, go ahead.
I was just gonna say two, at least, you know, 1 to 3 days rest. You know, as a general guideline. Yeah.
Quick thing on that too. I think a lot of people try to do more is better for training because they're trying to out-train their poor diet.
Yes. 100%. I agree with that. And again, something that I did for a long time as well until reality slapped me in the face. And I was like, oh, I can't actually do that. But as soon as you have both hand in hand, the work to rest ratio that we talked about and a appropriate amount that is realistic for you. It doesn't have to be the most optimal, but what is actually most optimal is what's going to be most sustainable and realistic for you, for your lifestyle. And just making sure that, you know, you're enjoying the process as well. And you're taking care of your nutrition, like Kristen said. If you're doing one without the other, you're going to see a dampened result. But when you start doing both hand in hand, you will be shocked and awed by what can happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you see the question, Masha? Am I pronouncing that right? Let me know.
Yeah.
She said, what are your thoughts about recovery week?
Yes. So recovery week, I think that if I'm understanding the question correctly, you mean like a deload week where you don't do any training?
I think she means, yeah, don't do any training.
Okay, so no training for a week. There's a lot of ways to actually deload. There's kind of a way to do it where you take the full week off. It just depends on really like personal preference. I have yet to do a ton of research on what is actually more beneficial. And honestly, I think it comes down to an individual basis preference and what your body works with the best, honestly. I've taken a full week off from training and it has felt absolutely amazing. If you want to take a week off from training, like this is a lifestyle. Take the week off of training. It's not the end of the world. Sometimes life happens and sometimes you just really feel like you need the break, whether that's mentally or physically, it's okay. And you don't need to guilt yourself about it. Your body is only going to take that rest and recovery time so much better. It's kind of the same thing as taking your rest days, right? If you want to take it, make the decision, own it, and enjoy that rest so much. And when you go back the following week, your body's going to thank you and it's going to perform probably even better. You know, you won't be as sore. You'll probably be stronger from having all that rest because it's also something that you probably don't do all that often. Another way that you can kind of deload is, and sometimes I'll do this with clients when they have a really intense program, is the first week of your new program, of like a 4-week program, is already tough, right? It's a new stimulus or a new stress for your body to adapt to. So I like to call it like a get to know your program type of week. Right? You're getting used to those exercises. You're still finding a working weight that is challenging, but you're not going, excuse the expression, balls to the wall and obliterating your muscles, right? You're not going in there with the intention of like, I'm going to destroy and, you know, I'm going to do like an RPE or rate of perceived exertion. It's like how hard the exercise is to do of like 9 or 10 on every exercise. Cause it's just not realistic and it's not necessary for the result. So taking that first week to feel out the movements, get comfortable, find a weight that's a comfortable starting point for you for each exercise. And just focusing on the mind to muscle connection, the tempo, following your rest times and letting your body get used to that new training program is another way to do it too. And then week 2 rolls along and you're ready to dive in. Is that, how do you think about that, Kristen? Anything to add?
Yeah, I would agree. My only concern is how often are you doing it, right? Yeah. It shouldn't be very often. It should be a very rare thing. I've had probably 3 women of my entire time of training, which is a lot of women. I think I've had 3 and I've given them a week off.
Yeah.
In addition to giving them a week off of tracking macros, we pulled back. We had some controls in place, but their body, their mind, the stress that was, the external stress that was going on, they really needed it. And so we checked in every day. We chatted every day, but I strictly told them, take some space, but I said, make it an active recovery. Go on walks, go on hikes, go to the river, go to the beach, do things that fill your cup. So it was mainly like a let's fill your cup up week, take the stress off of tracking, take the stress off of training and do things with loved ones. But then, bam, the week is over, check in, you ready? Yep, I'm ready, feeling great. Right back on track.
Yeah, I love that so much. That's amazing. It's so important because like exercise is structured. It's structured exercise, but non-structured exercise or activity is also important too. And doing those things that fill your cup and make you feel like you're enjoying it, especially if you're in a place where sometimes we're not enjoying our training. And it does get to that. I think Kristen talked about that in her stories last week sometimes, and it's totally normal. But you definitely shouldn't be taking a full deload week. Like, don't do it every month. You don't need to do it every month. Your body simply doesn't need it. And I think that maybe I've taken, you know, a couple deloads in my entire like training career. And maybe I would say like maybe 2 to 3 times a year, if you really need it, if you're really training intensely, like I would say that that's like really what is maybe needed. But it also depends on the way that you want to deload too. I would say that that's mainly for like athletes, but if you're somebody who trains like an athlete, you train really intensely, I think that's okay.
Yeah. Yeah. I agree. I think I do it twice a year about as well.
Yeah.
Tiara is saying being an ICU COVID nurse has been hard. I cannot even imagine. We work with a lot of nurses randomly. We have a lot of nurses and a lot of real estate agents, but I think it's because both of those people's lives are insane and they need help with balance and schedule and mindset, learning to fill your cup up. Like that's a lot going on.
Yeah.
There's always a solution, ladies. There's always a solution. I'm looking at Shannon. Don't feel bad. Don't feel bad about anything. There's always a solution. This is why we need trainers. Jessica and I have a trainer. We work with the same guy, Tom Brazier. Yep. A, we like to keep our skill exceptionally sharp. But B, if you want to be fit, healthy, have balance, have accountability, and make progress forever, have a trainer. I will have a trainer for the rest of my life.
Me too. 100%. It does. It's the emotion is out of it, right? Like even as fitness professionals, we could do it ourselves, but it's a lot. It's a lot to separate yourself from your own journey, right? So it's just so much fun to have a coach too. You always learn something new.
Yeah, sure. Like he's having me do a landmine rows.
Ooh.
I don't think it's called that, but it's, you know, the bars out this way and you're rowing and I'm like trying to figure out the movement. Actually, I think I posted it yesterday. Like that's a new one, you know? So I'm like, that's pretty cool. And he's in London, for those who don't know him, he's a WBFF trainer, World Beauty Fitness and Fashion. He's
so good.
Okay, like we'll get off that because he is amazing. You all should look him up. But cool because, you know, he's on a completely different side of the world and new exercises are being invented all the time. And so it's so cool. Like we have a lot of different leaders that we train and learn under, but it's good to have a full scope because it's like everyone has different philosophy. Everyone does different research. Exercise research, physiology research, mental health research, which we follow, neuroscience, like tons of stuff. So it's great because the more counsel you have over you, the smarter you'll be.
Yeah.
That's the easiest way to put it.
Yeah.
Okay, Jess, do you want to do one more and then I'll go into some other stuff with them?
Absolutely. So the big one, the question of the day maybe, is how often should I train my glutes? How many days per week should we train our glutes? So if you are somebody who is trying to grow their glutes, please drop a peach in the comments. I want to see, I want to hear you, hear us roar. I am always trying to grow my glutes. I feel like they can never be big enough, to be honest.
I agree.
What did you say?
I said, I agree. I love it.
Yeah, I see all these peaches coming in. I love it. Okay. So glutes are a huge muscle. They're actually one of the most powerful muscles in your body. I think they're actually the strongest muscle in your body.
Oh, I don't know.
The most force is what I have been taught, which is very interesting. But so when we train our glutes,
I thought it was back.
Really?
Glutes? We'll dig into the research and we'll let you know.
But I have always been taught that glutes can produce a large amount of force from the body, right? But we will definitely dig into the research. So glutes respond really, really well to volume and frequency. So frequency is the amount of times that you train them throughout the week. And volume is the amount of like reps that you do in a training session over the entire week. Right? Because volume is the amount of reps overall. So the optimal set range for muscle growth, if that was a priority muscle in your program, which for a lot of us ladies, it will be, is 24 sets over the entire week. So you can sprinkle that over multiple training days. So that's why I say 2 to 3 times per week, because you don't want to be in there just doing a glute day, completely obliterating your glutes for 24 sets in one glute day. I mean, you could, but it probably wouldn't be the most optimal. And because we know that glutes respond really well to frequency too, hitting them multiple times a week can be really beneficial for rest and recovery and optimal performance as well. And I think that when you recover better that way, you see more growth, has been my experience. So with training your glutes though, one really common thing that I find is not training the entire glute. And Kristen, I know that we've talked about this. A lot of us will find exercises, and this is what I mean by consider the source if you're looking on Instagram. We'll find exercises online, and those exercises will be geared towards, like, you've seen those videos, like shaping your underbum or something like that, right? But they're lower glute exercises. So then what actually happens is that area might get really strong and it might start to get, you know, firmer and feel better and feel tighter, which is great and more shapely, but then we're neglecting the rest of our glutes, which is a problem for strength and functionality, but also for that big butt aesthetic that we're going for, right?
So saggy, even if you're training, if you're just training the lower part, your butt still looks saggy.
Yeah, exactly. Because all of those muscles have to work together to be able to create that shape that you want and to be able to function well together. Think of it as a group of muscles, your glutes, right? You have your glute medius, right? Your glute minimus and your glute max. And they all work together in pretty much every glute movement that you're going to do. Some are more biased towards working one area. And that's what I mean by training all areas of your glutes. Like, for example, you guys know those machines where you're sitting on it, the hip abductions, and you're abducting outwards. The good girl, bad girl. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh my God, I've never heard it put like that.
You're gonna love it, but you guys know what I'm saying. So when you're sitting in the seat and you're moving to the side, this is a really awkward angle, but you're pushing your legs apart into the pads, right? And that's actually working your glute medius. So the actions of the glutes all need to be worked. Otherwise, they're not going to get that nice round shape that you want. And you might actually end up having some pain because it will cause compensation in other areas of your body, not just your glutes. So low back pain is a really common thing for glutes that are not functioning correctly. If you have pain anywhere in your body, it's a sign that, and you're working out, it's a sign that one of your movement patterns needs fixing, your form needs fixing. So just pay attention to that. I'm glad that I could give everybody a good laugh, and hopefully we all know what hip abductions are. I feel like us ladies do, but I had to take it there. So just make sure that you're training all areas of your glutes. So like in the shortened position, in the lengthened position, I'm actually going to make a post about this tomorrow too, is what areas, like what movements we need to train our glutes in, what movement patterns. So actually, if you're okay with it, I'm going to pull it up so that I can give everybody that information. So I think it's going to be really helpful so that when you guys are looking on Instagram, right, or even if you have a coach or you hire a coach, like you kind of know for yourself too, this knowledge is lifelong. The more that you learn, the more empowered you're going to be in your journey. So we need to train our glutes in a hip thrust or a hip bridge, right? So that's called hip extension. And it's one of the actions of the glutes, right? It's actually, that exercise is hardest in the contracted position. So when we're at the top of our hip thrust, right? When your glutes are fully squeezed, that's when it's the hardest. But that is one of the best exercises for glute strength and glute growth, because it is one of the main functions of your glutes is to extend your hip. So the next thing, sorry?
I would say that's like one of the best ways to isolate your glutes. Your hamstrings and other muscles still work, but you know, we have like bench press for chest. We have shoulder press for shoulders. Hip thrust is for glutes.
Yeah, it is like the compound exercise for your glutes. It's going to work the entire glutes too, which is fantastic. Yeah.
Thank you, Brett Contreras.
Thank you, Brett Contreras. Exactly. The glute guy. If you haven't heard of him, you should look them up. The next one is like a squat or a lunge pattern. Yeah, the Glute Lab. Oh my gosh, I need to get that book. I really
so do. Good. I have Booty Queen was created out of Glute Lab.
Love that so much. Yeah, the man is a legend. He knows his things. He knows he's the butt guy for a reason. I love that you have that book. So. The next movement pattern is the squat or lunge pattern, which is an emphasis on your lower glutes and your quads, right? We've all seen, most of us know that you can bias. So focus on your quads or your glutes doing a lunge, depending on the angle of your shin and your torso, right? So that's a really important one. And that one is hardest in the stretch position, right? When you're at the bottom and you really feel it in your glute or your quad, that nice burn. But it's really important to be training your glutes in this position as well. The next one is a hinge or a pull. So the hip hinge, right? Like the 45 degree back extension, a deadlift.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. So a hip hinge, she's leading with her hips, right? Pushing her butt to the back of the room.
That I use the cue as kiss your butt to the ceiling, because otherwise some women actually try to bend, but I'm like, oh, get the stretch in your hips. Think about it. Like, I don't know how many have seen like that bird that, you know, like southern pecs. It's the same thing. You're just using your hips.
Yeah. That's true. That's a great cue, actually. The butt kissing the ceiling. I've used that in myself with an RDL. World of a difference. World of a difference. is there anybody else? Yes, but you all are. That's so funny. So yeah, there's tons of hinge patterns, right? It could be single leg deadlift variations. Like, there's tons of hip hinge patterns, which is really great because it means that we can use it as a form of progressive overload. We're never going to get bored of our exercises. We've always got one to turn to in all of these areas to use in our programming, the woodpecker. That's all I'm envisioning now is the woodpecker. Okay, so the last one is abduction, which is what we talked about. And if you've never heard the term, I did refer to them as good girl, bad girls. But the abduction is also a function of the glutes. So abduction means moving away from the center line of your body. Adduction, adduction is moving inward. So we're talking about hip abduction, abduction. So that's moving your glute, moving your leg outside of the midline of your body, right? We've all seen it done with a cable, the standing cable one. You can do it with a band. There's tons of ways to do it, but that is the last movement pattern that we want to be perfect, Kristen. Thank you so much. That's the last movement pattern that we want to be training our glutes in. If you're training in all four of those areas, you're going to start to see a huge, huge difference. It does not have to be the same exercises.
I didn't mean to pop that up while you were talking. I was hoping it would go in the background. So I'm gonna pop up a list of exercises for your upper glute, which makes your glute like lifted, for your mid glute, and then for your lower glute. So I want you to screenshot it. I'll give you a second.
I love this.
Oops. Okay. I just closed it.
Ridiculous. Got it. Just kidding. No.
That's all you get. Did you get it?
So savage.
Okay, good. I'll give you guys just another second. Go ahead, screenshot it. So in your training program, you want all of them. What I personally do is I'm like, okay, what part of the glute do I want prioritized this phase? If I want to grow their upper glute for this phase, then Monday, when you're most rested, when you have the most psych, when you have the most in you, slam that upper glute and do mid and lower glute throughout the week. Okay, next phase, bam, I want to focus on my mid glute now. Prioritize in the beginning of your workout set, like of your workout in the day, put it on the top and put it in the front of your week. Whatever muscle you want to grow most for that phase of training. When I say phase, like, we usually take our women through 4 week phases, 3 to 4 week phases. Then we change their entire regime. So each phase we have different focuses and different priorities. I hope that makes sense. That's kind of a random thing.
No, it makes perfect sense.
Are we ready to move on? Okay, ladies. So now here is the problem that we have seen over and over and over. I have literally worked with over 500 women in this capacity, and this is the problem that I see most. You make great progress, and then you go backwards. Then you make great progress, and then you go backwards. And then you make great progress, and then you go backwards. And it's like a cycle of winning, now I feel defeated. Winning, now I feel defeated. It's very hard. It's very challenging on the mind. Drop a one if you have felt like that. Let me make sure that y'all are connecting with just some problem awareness and some solutions that I'm going to give around this. So if you feel like that is you, or if you feel like you've been able to get to your desired outcome, but it's so challenging to maintain, it takes way too much effort, and it's just a little bit frustrating. Same, drop a one. Yeah, okay, cool. If that's you. Okay. A question we get asked all the time, Kristen, Jessica, please, can I get my results, and maintain for life without the stress, without the overwhelm, without all the challenge. Move it as a lifestyle and just enjoy. Sit back. It's like brushing my teeth. Life is good. Da da da. Yes. The answer is yes. Does it take time? Yes. Right? Why? Because we have to change habits. We have to change lifestyle, not in a restrict. That's me beating, right? Restrict. We don't have to do that. It's just small lifestyle habits that then compound to like, oh my God, this is so easy. How have I not been on this other side for all this time, right? So this is why we created this thing called the Ultimate Physique Program. It's a way for you to have your results in the weight room, get control over your nutrition in a fun, a balanced, and in a very enjoyable way, get you to your goals super efficiently, and then teach you how to maintain it, okay? So if it is okay with you, I want to tell you guys about that, just about our services, how we work with women. See if it resonates with you. If it does, fantastic. We'll chat more about it. We'll jump on a call. We'll talk about your goals, really why they're important to you, where you're at, where you want to go, how we can support you. And then we can decide, is it a good fit? Are we a good fit for each other? So if that's okay, cool. I got one thumbs up. Yeah, that's okay. Jamie, you're already a client.
Jamie, I love you.
I love it. Thank you, sweet girl. But if that's okay with you, ladies, we really want to chat about it because we love it. You know, we want to tell you how our process works. I know a ton of you guys have already booked calls yesterday. We're really excited to chat with you. We've already started a bit today. But for those who haven't, we just want to just chat with you more to see if it resonates.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So this is how our process works. So as we have been talking about this week, macros, right, nutrition, a huge problem is women are not eating the right macros for themselves. And so it's frustrating. You're spending all this time week after week tracking, not seeing results or seeing very minimal results. So the very first thing we do is get you customized macros for you, your lifestyle, your goals, your dream goals. Dream goals. Every time we're on calls with them, we're like, no limits. Go. What else? What else? Yeah. What else do you want? What else do you want? What else? Because we can help you achieve it. Anything you want. Don't limit yourself. Limitations in your mind. Okay. As Macklemore says, we create our ceilings. We really do. That lyric was life changing.
That lyric is life changing. I know exactly the one you're talking about.
So we'll get you on the right macros. If your goal is weight loss, we like our ladies to lose about a pound and a half per week. Some women come in, they don't want weight loss. They want to either maintain or go in a surplus to gain muscle. We can do anything for your goal. Most women are weight loss, which is why we typically talk about that. We'll teach you how to effectively track so easily, so you feel comfortable. We can do a little bit of meal plan support if you need it. You have unlimited access to WhatsApp, which is, if you're not familiar, it's like texting basically. So much support. Like, I'm not joking. Even the girls who are our clients, please tell me how supported you feel. No lie. You just share it. Okay. The second thing we do, and actually, let me ask you this. How many of you truly, truly enjoy weightlifting? Really actually like it? Drop a two. Do you actually like to go in the gym, pick things up, put them back down? While listening to music.
I pick it up and put it down.
I pick up big things and I put them back down. But we do it with perfect form.
Yeah, yes. We do.
Good. I'm glad these twos are coming in. Yeah. And good. I love it. And if you don't love weightlifting, maybe ask yourself why, right? It could just be there's no clear, not endpoint, but there's no clear destination. So it comes up like, why am I even doing this? Mm-hmm. How many enjoy weightlifting, but don't feel like they're making that much progress? You're in the gym, you're training hard, and you're like, this is making me mad. I'm doing all the right things. Why am I not making more progress? Oh, I love that, Allison. Okay, so this is why we give you weightlifting routine, changes every 4 weeks, but here is a very clear difference of Iron Goddess coaching to most trainers and programs out there. A is very, very strategic program design. So all the progressive overload is in there automatically. So you're always going to be making, you're always going to get results week after week after week after week. Your body will change and you will get results. Make sure you're pushing yourself in the gym, okay? But the other thing, we are shaping your body. We're not just going to the gym like, cool, let's like work out our back, let's squat. You know, like just doing exercises, right? That's great, but you're already spending the time in the gym. Let's get the maximum benefit we can possibly freaking get, right? So we're like, let's train your shoulder this way, then this way, then this way, then this way, then this way. Like all the ways that are so complicated to think about that people who don't do this 24/7 just don't have the time to think about, to program, to put it together, to package it up and be like, go lift, right? Yeah. It's impossible. Yeah. So that's what we do. So workouts change every 4 weeks, about sometimes three, like I said, to keep you excited, to keep your body changing, to prevent you from adapting and plateauing. It's really awesome. We shape you to that lean, toned hourglass figure. So what I mean by that is beautiful toned shoulders, strong body, lean arms naturally, but not like noodle arms. Like we really develop your shoulder, develop your back, bring in the waist quite a bit, nice little tight waist, and then beautiful booty, healthy, shaped, fit, strong. And then we tone up your legs, okay?
Yes.
Okay. Now, on top of this, accountability support is vital. So like I said, we do What's That. We have two live support calls every week. I run one on Tuesday, Jess run ones on Friday. If you just want extra support, help me through this, help me through this. I'm struggling here. I'm feeling this here. Jump on. Let's chat. If you can't make the call, we schedule one-on-ones. Like I'm telling you, it is so, so much support. You'll never be left like, where'd my coach go? That it's like impossible in this program, honestly. But we also do weekly check-ins. So every Sunday morning, before you eat, before you drink, after the bathroom, if possible, you do measurements. So waist, low belly, hips, and two on your thigh to make sure, right, we're getting a great result. You'll take progress photos. Bam, 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 right? And then we track your weight. We also track your sleep, your menstrual cycle, your energy, your stress, all of that, because fat loss is stress management. So let's say you're nailing macros, you're nailing your workouts, but your stress is through the roof. Your body's not changing. What would you do? I'm eating too much. I have to work out more. No, no. Actually, you're not sleeping enough. Actually, let's talk about how we can lower stress. This is a huge reason why having a coach is so vital, because without it, you're looking at nutrition and weightlifting. I need to do more, which is adding more stress on your body and will either cause you, what's the word? A crash, but it's like, what's what I'm looking for? It's like a physical and mental crash. Your stress is too high. You think you need to do more. So you do more, adding more to your stress. Bam, you could cause injury. You cause a lot of mental issues. Like, is just not a good idea. So that's why we track the whole lifestyle of the woman. We help you find solution to problems you're facing, any challenges you're facing. My schedule is so insane. I don't have time for any of this. No problem. Let's sit. We'll chat through it. Let's talk. Where can we pull back? Where can we add in a little bit of activity? You don't have time for an hour workout. Who said your workout needs to be an hour? You only have time for a half hour? Beautiful. Let's maximize our half hour. Take all the fat off through nutrition, because we can accomplish any fat loss through nutrition only. Weightlifting is for bone strength, functional life, high quality life, being strong and shaping your body so you feel confident in your skin. But fat loss can fully be accomplished through nutrition, which is great peace of mind, right? Okay, beautiful. So I'm going to share, so go ahead, drop a three if any of you relate to that, if that sounds good, if you're like, oh my God, what? Like, okay, fine, that's not interesting. So while you're doing that, I'm going, and let me know if you have questions. I'm going to share a couple of success stories with some of my clients. You can share some of yours as well, but I'll share a few of mine.
For sure.
Miss Julie, my love, I love this woman. She has trained with me for about a year and a half now, actually. She's amazing. She came to me very depressed, heavier than she's ever been in her life, when we did our strategy call, I'm not joking. I almost started crying because she was so sad. And, you know, we just talked. She'd never done anything like that. I don't remember if she had ever lifted before, but she definitely did not work out. She didn't watch what she ate. Like, there was nothing there. Okay. Very, very depressed. Marriage was like, it was a real bad situation. On depression medication, all that. So brought her in, got her on the right macros, got her on a weightlifting routine. We had all the accountability, just like, you know, I was sharing with you. Oh my God, how many pounds has she lost? Let me actually see if I can, let me pull up a quick picture. And actually the picture I have is not updated. Her after photo is not even updated. Within the first 12 weeks, she was off depression medication. She got her marriage back. Her and her husband were starting to have a much better marriage when it was like not a good situation. No, it was not a good situation. Here, let me download this page 4. She got her marriage back. So for years and years and years, she didn't want to go sit at the pool with her girlfriends. Every summer, her and her girlfriends, the kids go play at the pool park, and she would never do it. She would have big baggy clothes. She would never wear her bathing suit. She dreaded it every year. Like, what kind of quality of life is that? This past summer, she got her bikini, or I don't know if it was bikini. She got her swimsuit. She went and played with the kids. She went and played at the lake all summer. She said she has never had so much fun. And I'm like, dude, it's because your weight and all this crap was basically stealing your life. And that's not cool. Here is just her front photo. But you guys have to remember, it's not just about body. It's your mind and your life. What happens in your mind and your life. Like, it's so much more. Okay. So anyway, she learned how to track her macros. She got really successful at tracking her macros. She started to learn, like, if she was craving one of her daughter's Pop-Tarts, she would like eat the Pop-Tart. Yes. And she used to feel guilty, go down this sprout. I'm like, no, we're not doing that. So we hammered mindset hard. She went through some ups and downs like we all do in life. But she had someone, me, right, a trainer, she had someone behind her saying, hello, hi, what's up, what's going on today? Feeling sad? Bam, get on a call with me. Let's chat right now, right? So it's just having someone with a solution mind, a solution-minded person, and a person coming from love, and a person saying, I care about you, I care about your results, your experience, your results are number one. Let's chat. Let's get you out of this as fast as we freaking can, right? She's amazing. Okay, Miss Annie, this queen. So she's been with us for, Annie, if you're on, let me know. I think she's been with us for 8 months now. She's in her second 6-month program. So she came to me and she was like, I got down to my goal weight in high school. She wanted to get to her high school weight. I believe, I don't want to say her age because I could be wrong on it. I don't like getting people's ages wrong. So scratch that. But anyway, so she got down. She's older than me. Okay. And I'm in my 30s. But she got down to her goal weight. And she's like, what is this? I don't even like my body. She was thin, basically. Mm-hmm. She's like, what the heck? She was working out all the time. She ate really healthy, watching what she ate, lived a great lifestyle. Everything was fabulous. But when she got to her goal, she didn't like it. So she came to me and she's like, I want to shape. And I want to add more muscle. I'm like, yes, right? So fun. So we put her in a calorie surplus for the first about, I'd say 20 weeks, actually. So 4.5 to 5 months. Put her in a calorie surplus, added a bunch of muscle mass in the right places, shaped her body. Now, then we put her in a cut for about 6 weeks. Now we're putting her back up to maintenance. So now she feels strong in the gym because we have our clients send workout videos as often as they want. Some of my girls send it to me every single day and we give them form feedback. We have apps where we can draw, we take videos, you know, we do all kinds of stuff so you can make sure you're lifting like exactly perfect, right? So she's super strong now. She has all the shape to her body and we just keep going. Like, it's amazing. She loves it. She's getting her doctorate right now. She's a mom of two. She has a full-time job. Like, it's insane. But we just find the ways to make it happen, to make it work. Okay. Now, my client, Morgan. Man. So she was with me. I used to do 12-week programs before Jessica even came. My business used to be called Kristen Elizabeth Coaching before it was Iron Goddess Coaching. So I did a 12-week program with her. I think this is what happened. I think she did a 12-week program. She took a month break, to try to do it on her own, came back for another 12-week program, or maybe she came back for 24. That's what happened. 12-week month break, came back for 24-week program, and then wanted to try it again by herself. So we do teach our clients, like, we want you to be successful without us. A lot of women just want to stay, like, with us. Like, we'll have a trainer forever because we love it. But some people just want to try it themselves. And so we make sure you have the education, the tools, the knowledge, the confidence to be able to do that. I think she's almost down 100 pounds now. She came to me fresh out of a divorce, single mom, heaviest she had ever been in her life, so uncomfortable in her own skin, and truly, truly was at rock bottom. I just checked in with her a couple days ago. She's like, I am the lightest I've ever been in my entire adult life. She's like, I'm so happy. I'm thriving. All these people around me are starting to want to lose weight. Like, amazing transformation. What do all three have in common? They took the leap for themselves. They recognized they needed and wanted help. They took the leap for themselves. They followed the program to the best of their ability, and they all achieved insane results, as do every single other person in our program that say, okay, let's do it. I'll do that. It's like, I got you. Okay, cool. So who are, let me know if you ladies have questions at any time, okay? I know I'm like, bam, 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 all this information. So just let me know if you have questions. I get really jazzed up about this because I really like it. So, okay, so who do we look for? Who do we really like working with? Okay, we have a pretty broad range. I will say our program is pretty intensive in terms of there's no gap, right? We gather all the information pretty much about the whole woman, the whole lifestyle, to make sure that you're happy, you're healthy, you're creating new habits, all the things. So for someone who's just dabbling, like, I'm not sure if I really want a fitness lifestyle, might not be for you, unless you're like open to being bear hugged and like taking on the journey of health, like, then we got you. But if you are a baby beginner, but dedicated to results, we got you. We have had women that have like, I have never exercised an entire day of my life. I don't want to go to the gym. No problem. We're so flexible. We got you. We can get you at home with bands only. You'll probably eventually want to join a gym, but that's your call. But quick side note, I like to push my clients when they're ready into a gym, because if the reason they're not going is lack of confidence, part of the program that I do is I get them in the gym at some point for confidence reasons only, and they love it, and then they feel amazing. But I tell them, I'm like, most people in the gym don't know what they're doing. They just might look like they know what they're doing because you're new. So don't be afraid. Like, they're confused too.
Yeah. 100%.
Yeah. Okay. So if you are pretty comfortable but want to go to the next level, 100%, we got you. If you are slaying the gym and slaying your nutrition, getting great results, and want to take it to an elite level, we got you. 1,000,000%. We can get you to any physical and train your mind hard to really any result you want. Just communicate it first to make sure that we can accommodate. Yeah. Okay, so if you're like, oh my God, like nodding your head, like, oh my God, yeah. Let's see, what's my next number? I think a 4.
Yes.
Yes. Drop a 4. Let's get you on a call as soon as possible so you can start as soon as possible. There are gaps that we don't take clients. In fact, we're trying to move to only taking clients around event time so we can give so much attention just to our people, basically. So drop a 4. We'll get you on a call. It's a no obligation call. We'll just talk through it and decide if we're a good fit for each other. Okay. Last thing I want to tell you. I'm going to tell you about a personal story. Okay. So when I got off active duty, May of 2020, I decided to start this business. Now, I've been a trainer for 11 years, but it wasn't online, right? I was in-person trainer, training with the military, stuff like that. So May 2020, I had just been completely dropped by my ex-husband. Just vulnerable story. He deployed, had several affairs, got a chick pregnant when I was caring for our newborn. And he's like, actually, never mind. I don't want you guys anymore. I had decided to get out of the military. Excuse the middle finger. I apologize. I'm a woman of God. I apologize. But I'm like, we decided that I would get out of the military to support our child, AKA not work. So, and he would work. So we would rely on his income. And we had just bought a house. like 6 months prior in New York. And he just dropped us out of completely nowhere. And I was like, what? I have no money, nowhere to live. And I had a newborn. I'm like, is this some kind of a joke? Seriously, is this some kind of a joke? I was freaking out. The only thing I wanted to do was train. Not as like, that's the only thing I know how to do, because I was a military officer. You could do anything, right? Go work in Seaburn, whatever. But I love training because I remember what it was like to not be fit, not live a healthy lifestyle, and desperately wanting it, but just not knowing how, having no clear direction, trying random things like eating a fat bowl of plain yakisoba noodles to hit carbs. Like, it was insane. My God, what was I doing? But anyway, and so I told myself, I will never let another woman desire that lifestyle, that physique, that mindset, and not know how to get there. I'll bridge that gap. And I was like, it's now or never. I had 4 months of money, basically, until I completely ran out, and then nothing. And I was like, let's go. I hired a business coach, $10,000. I had no job. I had no job. So I refinanced my car to get $10,000 of cash, and I freaking paid her. I met her on Facebook. I knew her for like a week, but I loved her energy. I was like, you seem like you know what you're talking about. And I just handed her $10,000 cash, and I'm like, let's go. Best decision of my life. Was it scary? Yes. Did I cry? I can't tell you how many buckets I probably filled, or how much wine I drank, or like how much fear was involved. But what I did, one foot in front of the other, one foot in front of the other, one foot in front of the other. What if I can't do it? But you can, because I desired it, because I desire to serve women in this capacity. I wasn't going to allow fear to hold back value and life change for all of these women that truly wanted it, right? So if you're letting yourself be held back by like, what if I can't do it? What if I can't commit? What do you mean, what if you can't commit? You can commit. And if you can't, you have that voice being like, hello, come on. We're always there. So don't be afraid. You can know zero. Someone are like, I need to get in control of my nutrition before I join. I'm like, what? That's what we teach you to do. Let's get in control of your nutrition. You don't have to be doing anything. We'll take you to the most thriving level where you're like, this is the best.
Yeah. Grab you by the hand and take you where you want to go.
Mm-hmm. In a really loving and supportive way. Very educational. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we preach. We want to introduce you to this thing called a fast action bonus. This is to really honor the women that are like, let's go. I'm doing it. Right. And even if you're not nervous, awesome. You'll still get it. Also, for the women who booked their call this week, we know a lot of you have, you will also get it as well, okay? If you book a call in your next 24 hours with us, free strategy call to talk through your goals, what you want. If you book in the next 24 hours, we are going to give you exclusive access to my mindset speech therapy and my behavioral training classes. This is brand new that we're doing. We're actually creating this very high level VIP offer for women after they go through their first program to have access to this like insane thing. We have not even launched it yet, but that is something I want to offer to you ladies, because that is a huge piece that we need. Mental health, mindset health, easy behavioral change, and support in that area. Is it like therapy? A little bit, but very solution oriented. Instead of like, tell me how you feel. We're going to dig deep into roots that are causing issues in life. We're going to dig deep into your language, how you speak to yourself. We're going to dig deep into how can we shift that language, which will shift your perspective, which will shift your relationships, your work, your life, how you think, how you feel. Everything will change. So you will get exclusive access to that. And I think, Jess, I haven't talked to you about this, but I think I want to make it for a year instead of 6 months. So yeah. So that is that, ladies. That is all I have. So we would really love to chat with you. We're here for it. This is like the love of our life.
True. Seriously. Yeah. Wake up every day grateful, grateful for my clients, grateful for this company, and just like excited. If you love what you do, you've felt that too. It's a beautiful thing.
Jessica's like, you need a break. I'm like, I get a break all the time. She's like, I'm like, I love working. I'm like, I don't care.
Yeah, it It's like a party. She's like, I've got my coffee. I'm ready to go.
It is. It's so fun. I'm like programming our next workout. I'm like, Jessica, I'm nerding out so hard. I'm like, listen to this. Like, I'm so excited.
I love it. It's the most amazing feeling.
Cool, ladies. Well, thank you for listening. Thank you for being here. We love you. Tomorrow, we're going to have a couple special guests from our clients just share their experience, just share like what it's done for them, you know, what this practice has specifically done for them. Instead of hearing it from us, we'll have you hear it from them. Jessica will be on with some of her gals.
Yeah,
it'll be a great time. So thank you, ladies. Jess, anything that you want to add?
I'm just super grateful for all of you being here. I hope that you're all learning as much as you want. And again, just a reminder to like ask questions, like ask all the questions. We're here for that. We're here for teaching you too. So just thank you so much for being here. Thank you for being present and engaged and making it fun and commenting peaches. I appreciate that. But I'm really excited to hop on tomorrow and have our ladies share with you. It's going to be really fun. Yeah.
Oh, don't forget, we're still giving away two programs. Tomorrow, we'll give them away. So, I love you guys. So the most engaged ladies will win. If you are already a client, you can still win. And we'll put 12 weeks on your program at the back end.
100%.
I think we had, who won? Oh, Leah.
Yeah.
A couple of our new girls.
Yeah. No, it's beautiful. Get engaged. Get your name in there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Awesome. Emily, girlfriend, you need to come on our team for real though. Ladies, I'm like, Emily, we've been chatting. All right, ladies, have a great day. We'll talk to you later. Be strong today, mentally and physically. Love you.
Love you guys. Have a great day.